Recently I had one of my students ask me, "Mr. G, why do you always wave like this?" And the truth is, I'm not really waving. It's an alligator saying hello, obviously. All the other teachers have mascots for their rooms. For example, the fourth graders have got beavers and foxes and bears. Oh my. But for the art students, our mascot is the alligator. In fact, for our art club last year, that was our logo, the alligator. So if you're an artist, and I know you're an artist, I'm giving you the secret wave that is just for artists. And if you're ever walking down the hall or you see somebody and you're not sure if they're an artist, well, just say hello. If they say hello back, well, then you know that they're an artist. So if you're an artist and you're ready, we'll get started. Well, anyone who knows me knows that I love to stay on top of everything that's hip and trendy and happening. TikTok and Twitter and Instagram, Ash Brown. And one of the things that I noticed that's very popular right now are sea shanties. Now, sea shanties are songs, or it's a style of song that was very popular hundreds of years ago. They're the songs that were sung by sailors and pirates and men working on the docks. It provided them with a sense of entertainment. They would sing to keep themselves entertained. They would sing to encourage each other and to develop a sense of camaraderie. And also, the rhythmic structure of these songs would help them as they were doing very difficult labors, loading and unloading the ship, working the docks, maybe even rowing a boat. So with that in mind, I thought our drawing today would be of a big sailing vessel, maybe a pirate ship or a whaling ship, whatever kind of ship you want to draw. And we're going to start out with a line right near the bottom of our picture, not right at the bottom, but we're going to draw a straight line right near the bottom of our picture. And I don't need my ruler because what I'm drawing right now is the ocean. So of course that doesn't need to be perfectly straight. Now I'm drawing kind of dark, but you should keep your lines light so that if you want to make a change, you can erase it. And you can see how I went straight across and I left myself a little bit of room on this side and a little bit of room on this side. So if you haven't drawn it yet, go ahead and draw a fairly straight line along the bottom of the paper to show the bottom of our boat and the top of our ocean. We're going to turn this into waves a little bit later, and it's going to be easier if you drew your lines light. Now, after you've drawn this line right here, we're going to draw the back of the boat. And it goes almost straight up, but I'm giving it a little bit of a curve. The front of the boat has got more of an angle to it. So you can see it doesn't go straight up, it doesn't go straight across, it goes about halfway between straight up and straight across. Now I have the front of my boat, the bow, and the back of the boat, which is called the aft, if I'm not mistaken. A-F-T. The aft. So draw those two lines if you haven't drawn them yet. Again, I'm drawing them dark so that you can see them, but you should draw them light enough so that you can erase it. After I've drawn the back and the front of my boat, I'm going to draw another straight line that goes all the way across. Go ahead and do that if you haven't done it yet. I'm going over it a few times so that you can see my line better. But basically, it just goes from the front all the way to the back. After you have that line, I'm going to put a little scoop right in the middle. And I'm dividing my boat into pretty much three even segments. Here's the back segment. It's about the same size as the middle segment, which is about the same size as the front. And if yours isn't exactly the same, that's okay. Now I don't need this line anymore, so I'm going to erase it. And again, it's going to be much easier if I drew that line light. And already, it's starting to look like a sailing ship. I'm going to draw a railing, another line along the back, And then I'm going to draw some lines to show the railing of the ship. So I've drawn another line along the back of my boat, a little bit higher, and then a few lines to show the railing. If we've done that, we're ready to add our sail. In fact, we're going to have several sails. We're going to do maybe 5 or 6 sails because this is a big sailing ship. And I'm going to start right in the middle of my boat, and I'm going to go with a straight line. And you can see how big it is. It's just about the same size as that little section I drew out. I'm drawing a straight line just above my boat. And I'm going to draw another straight line. I'm going to go almost halfway up, but not quite halfway up. So here's the first line that I drew. And I'm going not quite halfway up. Halfway up from this line to the top of my paper would be right about here. I'm going to come down a little bit lower. Now, this is my biggest sail. And the line that I'm drawing right now is the same size as the line that I just drew. Go ahead and draw that line if you haven't drawn it yet. And from the top line to the bottom line, I'm going to make a little curve. And then another curve right here. So take a minute if you haven't done it yet and go ahead and draw the main sail of our sailing ship right there in the middle of our boat. After you've drawn this, we're going to do the same thing again. I'm going to draw another straight line. This time it's very close to my sail. And a straight line right above it. This sail is a little bit smaller. But I'm going to finish it off the same way that I did my first sail. So take a minute, if you haven't done it yet, and draw the second sail right in the middle of the boat. And I'm leaving myself a little bit of room on top for my flag. I'm going to darken my lines, and while I do, go ahead and draw both sails. After you've done that, right above this sail, I'm going to draw a little rectangle. It's not a square, because a square is the same on all sides. It's a rectangle. It's a little bit skinnier this way, or it's a little bit, pardon me, a little bit longer this way and a little bit skinnier this way. But it's a rectangle, and I'm going to put maybe 4 or 5 lines to show the crow's nest. Now, a crow's nest was the part of the ship where one sailor would climb up and take a spyglass and look out to see if there were other ships in the area, if there was land in the area, or if there were whales for them to hunt. And I'll draw a pole or a mast coming straight down. The last thing I have to do on this part of the ship is draw a flag. So there's just a pole going up. Go ahead and draw that pole. And then another square or rectangle. And you can decide for yourself what kind of a flag you want to have on the front of your ship. Could be an American flag. Could be a pirate flag. Could be any kind of flag that you want. But hopefully our ship is starting to take shape And now that we're experts at drawing sails, we're going to draw two more in front. And these sails are going to be a little bit smaller, but we know how to draw them now. We draw one curve and another curve, and then we connect them with a straight line. As you can see, this sail is a little bit smaller than my biggest sail. And I'm drawing it kind of light, so that if I'm not entirely happy with it, I can always make it bigger or smaller or move it forward or back, whatever I think I need to do. And on top of this sail, after I've completed this one, I'm going to draw another sail, but this time I'm going to make the shape a little bit different. I'm going to start with a straight line. I'm going to go up with a curve just like I did before, but this time I'm going to make it look like a triangle. Now it looks sort of like a triangle that's bent, and that's because the wind is blowing this way on our sail, but it's still basically a triangle shape. So if you haven't done it yet, go ahead and draw a triangle sail on the front of your ship. We're getting closer and closer to being finished. We need one more sail back here. And for the back sail, we're just going to make one big sail. And I'm going to start near the top, not right at the top, but near the top. And I'm going to draw one big curve. Now it's just like the curve that's the front of the sail and the back of the sail. It's not that much of a curve like a circle, but it's not quite like a straight line because we want to show that the wind is blowing. That's what's filling up the sails and that's what's moving our ship. I'm going to go straight across the bottom. And all I have to do now is connect them. I'm going to continue this mast or pole, and I'm going to draw a little bit of the pole right here and a little bit of the pole coming down to show that it's connected to the boat. And I could do the same thing here, but I'm going to draw just the one mast for now. Maybe I'll add two other masts afterwards, but for now, I'm going to have just the one. I'll add a few more details. Let's see, I'm going to put some portholes, some windows right here on the front. And these are just three circles. Nothing mysterious about that. Just three circles right here. And I'll put three more in back. Now, maybe you want to have two in the front and three in the back, or maybe you want to have two in the middle. Whatever you think looks right, that's what you should go ahead and do. Now, I said before that this was my ocean, so I'm going to make it look like waves. I'm just going to make this line look a little bit curved. So I'm going to draw a curved line here, and here, and here. I'm going to make this line nice and dark so that you can see it. But you don't have to draw quite so dark. And this line that I'm drawing right now is where the ship meets the ocean. But that's not the only part of the ocean that we want to draw. So I'm going to draw a straight line that goes about from the middle of my boat straight across. This is the line that separates the sky from the ocean, and the word for that, in case you don't know, it starts with an H. It's the horizon. Here's the horizon line in the back of the boat, and I'll draw one on the front of the boat. Maybe I'll draw one or two little birds over here, some seagulls. Just little curves. Two over here and one over here. You can put seagulls if you want to in your picture. If you draw them, don't make them very big, because we want to make our ship look very large. And if the birds are very big, it's going to make our boat look even smaller. And I think at this point, I am just about ready to add some detail and color to my ship. And if you're ready, we'll work on that together.
There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Bully of Tea. The winds blew up her bow, dipped down, oh, below my bully boys blow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Da 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 da. Before the boat had hit the water, the whale sail came up and caught her. Hands to the side, harping and fought her when she dived down low. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. No line was cut, no whale was freed. The captain's mind was not of greed, and he belonged to the whaleman's creed. She took that ship in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Da 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 da. For 40 days or even more, the line went slack, then tight once more. All boats were lost, there were only four, but still that whale did go. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. As far as affair, the fight's still on. The line's not cut and the whale's not gone. The wellerman makes his regular call to encourage the captain, crew and all. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
My sailing vessel is all finished. I made a couple of changes that I should point out. One is that I put masts on the back sail and the front two sails. I also added a bowsprit. That's what this pole in the front of a sailing vessel is called. It's called a bowsprit. And I made my flag a cougar flag. You can make your flag any kind of flag that you want. I hope that you enjoy drawing your sailing vessel. I hope you enjoy learning a little bit about sea shanties. And I certainly hope that you enjoy our next project that we do together. But until we get together again, stay creative, stay safe, stay cougar strong. We'll see you soon.